miss music. This is a miss music. This is a miss music. Tell them they're right to it. This is a miss music. 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 Tell them they're right to it.
Hey, what's going on? This is Cochise
And this is Droski.
And welcome to Immense Music
on TMIRadio.com.
We got a pretty good show for you today. We have little Ronny coming in, little Ronny MuthaF.
Oh yeah, and then we also gonna have MykFresh. Yeah.
And FamLife Ent, they gonna be here. You might know little Ronny MuthaF from that song "Throw That Ass in the Circle."
Yeah, throw that ass in the circle.
Yeah. Okay, mine's a pretty big hit down here, you know what I'm saying? But so that's a little later on. But for right now, you know, Mike Droski, man, how was your week been, man?
Man, it was pretty good considering all the rain. Man, every time I looked up, it was raining. I'm like, damn, man, it was like clouds everywhere. But hey, I appreciate it, you know, because come next month, we're going to be talking about how fucking hot and dry it is.
So. Yeah, they say April shower brings May flowers, but
hey. Well,
it seemed like it's showering more in May than in April. You know what I'm saying?
True that.
Yeah, man. Anything interesting happened last week to you?
Man, other than the rain, bro. Shoot. Let's see. Man, I finally got a couple of days off. I've been working my ass off trying to get this money.
Okay, that's a good thing.
Man, it's always a good thing. I'd rather be working too much than not enough.
Uh huh.
Hey, that's what I get the bills paid. Apparently.
Yep. Of course.
Yeah.
Well, man. Let me tell you a crazy story, dog.
Let me hear it. What you got?
All right. I saw on Facebook it was this girl's birthday, right?
Yeah.
So I sent her a message. Say happy birthday.
Uh-huh.
You know, it was a message, not on the wall. She gonna send me a message back. Say, why didn't you write it on my wall? That was weird. Exactly.
Does it matter? Oh, was she counting? Is it like likes and posts? I don't understand the thing about likes anyway. Do we get paid for those?
I mean, like if you get enough, you probably could get paid.
Ooh, you got a point. You
know? But I mean, I don't think
like, yeah, I'm gonna get paid on my birthday. I guess it's like birthday dollars.
Birthday dollars?
Yeah, I don't know. Man, we need to look into that.
Most definitely.
Oh yeah.
Man, the news coming up this week, the big news. Oh, everybody's been talking about
marijuana legalization.
You already know. Hate to say it.
Yeah, trying to get this vote going.
Know what I'm saying, but
hey, what you think, man? I'm hoping they get done. I love weed. I think I ain't the only one.
Hey, man, I'm not going to say I love it, but I would say it's not a bad thing, Ben. But and apparently, the House doesn't think it's that bad either in Texas.
I don't know what you're talking about. I'm in love with Mary Jane. I'm not the only one.
This dude.
Yeah, what you know? Hey.
Anyway, we're going to take it to a few commercials and some music, and then we'll be back with little Ronny and MykFresh. Immense Music.
TMIRadio.com. This is Mike Droski. Tune in to Immense Music from 12 to 2 every Saturday on TMIRadio.com. Local, national, global.
What's up? Welcome back to Immense Music. This is Cochise and Droski, man. You just heard that drop by Droski, man.
Hey, I hope y'all like that. Man, first time. Don't worry. Got plenty more to go.
Oh, yeah. We was in the studio a couple of days doing drops.
Yeah. Well, it take us a couple of days to do it.
You know what I mean.
Hey, it felt like, you know what I'm saying? Well, I was fucking up, but it's all good.
It'd have been easier if that weed bill went through, right?
Yeah, true that. Man, speaking of which, what y'all think about that? Man, it's been a long time since I burned one. But when I come back, hey, I think I'm going to have a have a burn one party. Everybody's invited. But, man, y'all got to bring it on.
How do you think it's going to affect, like, music at all? Like, the music industry at all? Any kind of way, shape, or form?
Besides it getting better. I don't know. I mean, more inspirational.
I don't know, because, I mean...
Well, you know, my thing is...
I can't really see it changing too much.
Nah.
But, I mean, I was just wondering.
The D-Boys might get... It might affect them most of all. Those are the only ones I see getting affected. Maybe walking. I mean,
you think they're gonna go from being gangsters to being entrepreneurs?
Of course, yeah, that's what's gonna happen. Provided they don't try to limit it, like, oh, you can only do two plants. You don't have two plants in your house. Only having that, man, that's that bullshit.
Well, you know that's what's gonna happen.
Yeah, I already know that's what's gonna happen. Lie,
yeah. Two plants.
They didn't say how big the plants could be, though.
A pound
could
hold one plant.
Yeah,
I mean,
know.
If you do it right.
Yeah.
You know, so you might wait 3 months for it to flower, and then you got nothing.
That mean you fucking up.
Anyway, this is not a weed show.
Yeah, moving on. Yeah,
it's the music show.
Yeah. Speaking of which, happy Mother's Day to all the ladies out there with the children.
Happy Mother's Day, Mom. Yeah. My mom didn't want to come on the show for Mother's Day. She refused. I asked her.
Yeah.
Many times.
Man, my mom, I don't think my mom listened to rap. She listened to gospel. So, it's all good. I still love you, Mom. Hey.
What you mean you still love her? She got to listen to rap for you to love her? What's that about?
It's all good. She know what it is. I mean... We just into two different things. We just into different things, period. You know? But, hey, it was just us two growing up, so I know she got my back, I got hers.
Yeah, that's such a sweet story.
Hey, it is.
A sweet story. Can we get some, like, violin music or something in the background, and then you can tell little bit about yourself?
Hey, I'm a mama's boy from day one.
That's good.
I ain't even scared to say so.
Hey, you shouldn't be. You shouldn't be.
Yeah.
Man, so that's good. An interesting story I read about is Prince is throwing a peace concert in Baltimore.
Yeah, I heard about that, and he's going to give like half the proceeds to charity, right?
It's possible.
Yeah,
I just know he's throwing the concert.
The other half, he's going to,
is he really going to charge for the concert?
I mean,
Prince?
Yeah, you know, and. Telling him. Like you said, it is Prince.
It is Prince, you know what I mean? I wouldn't have any problem.
My only thing is, I'm wondering, are the kids that are truly get affected by the police violence, do they really know who Prince is? Or are they really going to show up? Because, Prince is, I won't say an outdated artist, but he's an older guy. I mean, he's an older artist, and... I mean, I like Prince. But, I mean,
But mom listened to Prince. Their brother listened to Prince.
Yeah.
I mean, they had a family member that listened to Prince.
But, I mean, if you're 18 years old and your parent talking about, hey, I'm going to take you to this Prince peace rally. You're going to be like, who?
You know who it is.
It'll be like, they're going to like, you're Prince of what country? Is he still gonna be wearing the assless pants?
I can't get behind that, Mr. Droski. Prince is timeless. You can't like Michael Jackson. Would you miss a Michael Jackson concert? I don't think anybody missed a Michael Jackson concert. I don't think anybody missed a Prince concert.
Michael Jackson, he just iconic. Ain't nobody gonna miss Michael Jackson. I go to a hologram Michael Jackson concert.
Yeah.
It don't matter. In any black Michael Jackson, white Michael Jackson, I go to either one.
Anyway, I don't know. I think the kids know who he is.
Yeah, I mean, they know, but it's like, are they gonna be interested? You think?
Yeah, they're gonna be, and that's history, man. Yeah, that is history, and he got a new song called Baltimore too.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, he's supposed to be. Yeah. So, I mean, I think they'd be somewhat interested, but, it is what it is.
Question.
What's up?
So, this song called Baltimore, do you think he's trying to capitalize on what's going on, or do you think it's just truly to bring awareness about what's really going on?
I don't think Prince is really too much worried about capitalizing on this. I've never really. I mean, the stuff I've heard about Prince, it seemed like he had a song that I heard only played in like, Minnesota. Where's he from? Up there, Minnesota. It only played in Minnesota radio. So I mean,
okay.
I don't think he's at all trying to capitalize.
Yeah, I mean, Prince a cool dude. Apparently, he's pretty good at basketball too, according to Dave Chappelle.
Dave Chappelle.
Yeah.
Oh, man.
Yeah.
Anyway, we still here. Later on the show, we're supposed to have Little Ronny and MykFresh coming up.
Yeah, they'll be in the show later on. Stay tuned.
Yeah. You know what I'm saying? I hope they didn't get caught up by stalkers like Chris Brown.
Oh, man. Did anybody hear about that?
Everybody heard about that.
Man, apparently this girl was in this man's house for like 2 days.
2 days?
2 days. She thought he was coming back on Wednesday. He didn't come back till Thursday. She done cooked herself something to eat, left dishes in the sink. Like, hey,
all right.
You gonna stop? At least you could have washed your dishes. You could have washed and cleaned up after yourself.
She wasn't expecting them back.
Nah, she was expecting them back. She expected him to be back earlier.
Man, nah. When he wasn't back, she got comfortable and, you know.
I think she got comfortable when she let herself in.
Yeah, so she's like the black Goldilocks.
Yeah.
This is not hot enough. This bed isn't comfortable enough. Yeah. Take a shower. She done found her Papa Bear.
Yeah. Papa Breezy.
Oh, man. No. Yeah. Oh. Say it ain't so.
I guess so.
Yeah, but, hey, the dude had enough sense. He had enough wherewithal. He had the frame of mind to take a picture and post that stuff. So that's good.
Yeah, man, that's crazy. I mean, what would you do if you just came in and you just saw a random chick you didn't know in your house making herself comfortable?
Is this me now? And how she look?
I think that's every man's answer. What she look like?
If she's a 10,
man, most brothers like, hey, she's a 7. Yeah, cause how many 10s you gonna find to stalk? 10s ain't gotta stalk nobody. 10s are usually getting stalked.
Well, yeah, that's true. That's true.
Yeah,
I don't know.
Brothers, that long they got, she got a fat ass. Brothers gonna like, yeah, all right. As long as she ain't crazy.
But she gotta be crazy. Yeah. She's talking.
She let herself in. And apparently she must have a criminal background to know how to get in. So, hey.
You can Google anything. You can Google anything nowadays.
You can Google how to break into.
Yeah, man. Well, they got a show called Life Hacks that this white dude goes around and shows you how to. He breaks into stuff and then shows you what not to do. He's like, if you do this, then he breaks into your house. And then
Life Hacks was to make life easier. Man, you know, it's like hacking into the house.
Maybe it's not called Life Hacks. This is a show I was watching. I was over at our boy Landon's house watching it.
Yeah, I know what you're talking about.
You know, did you do the show I'm talking about?
I know what Life Hacks are. I don't know about the show you're talking about.
Man,
we're gonna have to look that up, Google it on our Windows phone, because apparently
it was something.
Yeah, Android just ain't capable.
Man, get out of here with that.
Yeah,
but I mean, I don't know. The stalkers is a,
you know what?
Man, they gotta have them a lot. They gotta have it happen to them a lot, so they're probably tired of it. I mean, plus, if a stalker in my house, I'll probably kick her out. I definitely kick her out. But you might want to stay in contact if she's that interested in you.
True that. Like, what can you do? I mean, if she,
like, how interested are you? You want to bring me some chicken sometime, my love?
I bet if she'd have cleaned up, I bet he'd have kept her around
as a maid.
Yeah. Because what brother go turn down a maid?
I mean, a naked maid?
Yeah, definitely a naked maid. Yeah, because me personally, hot.
So you saying instead of calling the police, he should have. He made a contract. You can stay here as long as you want, as long as you don't wear any clothes and clean.
Then she don't want to be getting paid.
Not just on the contract, but that sounds real, real bad saying that out loud. That sounds real, real bad. Anyway, we're going to take another commercial break. When we come back, hopefully we'll have Lil Ronny and MykFresh.
And FamLife Entertainment.
You know what I'm saying? They on the CP time.
Hey, it's all good. We'll see them when they get there.
Yeah, you know what I'm saying? All right, so this has been Immense Music.
On TMIRadio.com. Stay tuned.
Hey, what's up? This is Cochise and Droski. We back In the building, we got MykFresh.
Yes, Lordy.
Yeah, we got to apologize. He was in the building on time.
In the building.
He was by the building.
I was looking for the building.
It's a little bit hard to find. I'll give him that, so yeah. I'll take that back.
You dig.
Yeah, all
right. Man. So how you been, man?
I've been pretty good. Just working on a lot of music, promoting Ghetto Gumbo. That's my mixtape and my single, my main.
Right.
Videos, shows, trying to step it up into the next level, you dig?
Right, man.
Feel that.
Shoot, you from New Orleans, right?
New Orleans, Louisiana, Third Wall.
And then you moved to Fort Worth, man.
Yes, Lord, Southwest Side.
When'd you move to Fort Worth?
2008.
Oh, so you was in New Orleans most of your life, yeah, man.
Katrina happened in 05. I moved to Fort Worth in 08.
So you stayed down there a few more years.
Going to a whole bunch of different little places around that time. I went to Missouri, went to Carolina, came to somewhere else in Texas, went back home, then came to Fort Worth.
Oh, really? Were you doing shows and rapping the whole time?
I ain't had nothing. I was gonna be no rapper. I was playing basketball at that time.
When'd you start rapping?
Yeah.
About 2010, I put my first song. I started in 2010.
2010? All right. Your uncle's Mystical.
Yeah, my cousin.
Your cousin. Mm-hmm. All right. Did he have anything to do with that?
He played a part in influence. Yeah. Like, I could do it because he did it.
Did he give you any kind of advice?
I talk to him from time to time. He'd be busy, you know what I'm saying?
I bet.
So it ain't a whole lot, but he give me a little advice when he can.
That's what's up.
Mm-hmm.
So, I mean, I know you probably done talked about it with him. Have y'all talked about any collabs?
Kinda. You know, it's in the works. I gotta step my game up before I mess with the big dog, you know what I'm saying? I gotta work and step my game up, but it's gonna happen.
Yeah. All right.
Man, You got your single, My Main, man.
Main chick up, beat a chick up. Hold on, this is internet radio, so can I be explicit or
what
we doing?
I got a question for you.
Say what the fuck you want to say.
I got
a question, first of all, about that. I read your bio, my man.
Uh-huh.
And your bio says something about no profanity.
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
Well, look. Okay. Well, the person who made that bio, at that time, I had a point to prove, like, that I can rap. So when I started off rapping, I was rapping without cussing. That was my way of, like, saying, like, I can rap without cussing because it's hard.
But after
a while, I was just like, you know, everybody know I've been cussing my whole life before I started rapping. So it was just like, let me start being me on the music. And that's when the music started popping. When I was rapping without cussing, wasn't nobody really, you know what I'm saying? They was just like, you got it, but alright.
Yeah, they weren't trying to hear it, huh?
Yeah.
I feel you. That's
but I feel that though, cause personally, they heard me cussing all day long, so when they hit me on the track, it's like, it's not too neat. Yeah,
so you saying the only time you don't cuss is you on the track?
Yeah, pretty much. That's what it was.
I was just wondering, cause Lil Wayne started like that. I'm like, that must be a New Orleans thing. It must be, if you can rap without cussing, bitch.
Well, you know, he inspired me, so that played a part in the inspiration of how I started, but not just that, I don't know if y'all know Comedian that did that too.
Yeah, okay.
I wanted to do it, because ain't no everybody rapping, bitch, fuck this, bitch, bitch, so I just had to start out like that, but now I'm grown, so that don't mean nothing.
So how old are you right now?
20.
20? Already. Yeah, because, which video was it? I don't know, I was checking it out, I think it was a kickback work. Man, it's like, hey, you 21, so
go get that liquor for me. Yeah, I'm 20. I ain't 21 yet.
I like that. I ain't gonna video tight.
Yo, we got a question for you, man. All right, we were talking about this before you came, man.
Right.
If Prince had a concert,
Prince,
would you be excited to go?
Of course.
See,
I don't know too much of his music. I know he a legend, and I know a lot of women love him, so I'll be there trying to, you know what I'm saying? Yeah. She was good with that. But as far as his artistry, I don't know too much about him, but I know he had a big impact, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, that was my thing. And so, mostly the women are going to be older women, huh?
Yeah.
And so, definitely. I mean, we all love older women.
We all love them. They love us young guys, you know what I'm saying? So,
That was my main thing. Because I was saying, I don't think the youngsters really going to be feeling Prince like that. That's just like...
Yeah.
Because what happened, Prince was throwing a benefit concert in Baltimore.
Okay.
And so we were saying that that'd be pretty cool, but he was saying that the people that are actually affecting that are mad and stuff
right.
wouldn't even know who he was.
Right, right.
And we were like, you about you young cat.
Yeah, yeah. If I was young out there, I wouldn't know he was neither, but I'd go to support the cause and to see the women.
Already,
so,
yeah,
it was all good.
I think
all
we
right,
like mine.
Yeah. All right, we're gonna go to some music right now. We have to go to your song, My Main. Can you talk a little bit about that before we go?
Yeah, My Main, bitch up, beat a bitch up, talk stupid, play foot, get fucked. You hear me? Really, I had a foursome and I wrote a song about it.
Word.
That's how the song came about. Now, just, you know, dissecting into that, you know, it's one main chick who, you know, who I'm rocking with at the moment, and you know, she don't let nothing else mess that up, you
right,
know what
right,
I mean?
Right,
I
right, right.
do what I do with 100,000 chicks, and she still like, nigga, they better not be in my position.
Right, right, right.
So,
right.
You know, man, you gotta respect that.
We're gonna listen to My Main, then we're gonna come back and talk more back about this four way.
Hey, welcome back. This is Cochise and Droski with the Immense Music. We're back, and little Ronny MuthaF has entered the building.
Yeah, I got lost, but I'm finally here, man. I'm finally here.
All right.
It's COVID, so him and FamLife and MykFresh are back.
Yep.
Shoot. So what kind of projects you guys got coming up?
Yeah, bro, you can talk for it.
Well, you know, I already told y'all about Ghetto Gumbo that's out.
Ghetto Gumbo.
And my next project is already done. It's called Ghetto Children.
I
ain't got no release date for y'all yet because I got stuff I'm coming out with before that. And I got a tape with this man right chilling around him, MuthaF, coming out too.
Oh, I forgot about
that. Lordy. See, we working hard. Yeah. Ain't no name yet. It's done, though. We'll leave that.
Been done since November.
You did.
At least
though,
your words, huh?
That's the hard part.
Hey, can I say the name of mine?
Yeah.
Oh, my tape called Wake the Fuck Up, man.
Wake
you know what I'm saying?
Up.
I ain't got a date on it, but it's all done. Pressed and everything, ready to go. And you know, it's self-explanatory, man. They sleep on me, man. But you know, I ain't gonna keep saying they sleep on me. I'm just gonna give them a tape. And while I'm giving them the tape, I'm gonna say, man, you need to wake the fuck up. Yeah. Just the world need to wake the fuck up. It's a lot of shit going on in the world right now. They need to wake the fuck up. It's just, you know, it's just gonna be the new terminology for motherfuckers that's lost on a lot of shit. Yeah. Like, you know what I'm saying? You don't know if your girl cheating, Fam, I'ma tap you in the show and say, wake the fuck up, man. I'm telling you, while you're at work, somebody over here, just wake the fuck. That's the new slogan, man. Wake the fuck up. Wake the fuck up. Wake the fuck up. Up. Yeah. MuthaF in the building. Let's go.
All right.
That's what's up. Man, so you've done a lot of stuff in the past, man. One of your most biggest hits, Third Ass in the Circle.
Yeah, most definitely.
Man, tell us a little bit, how'd that come about,
man? Man, it just random stuff, bro. I can't lie to you, just making music. It wasn't nothing that I thought was going to be no single. I was just making music like I usually do. And I gave it to a DJ in Oklahoma, DJ Wally Main. He was spinning a hook. Next thing you know, I started seeing tweets about it. Uh-huh. Me being an artist, I'm like, if I see too many tweets about a certain slogan or something like that, I'm gonna go make a song about it.
Okay.
So me knowing that that's my song that they doing, I'm like, I gotta release it now. He actually forced me to release it. Shout out to DJ Wally, man. Okay. He actually forced me to release that song, and from there it went. Speaking of that, the video is done.
For Third Ass in the Circle.
Video is done.
Done.
Let me tell you a little something, folks out there. You have not seen any Lil Ronny FamLife videos.
Yes. Boy. Go check them out. Man, boy, let me tell you, man. I don't know if y'all been to Chauncey's out here and all the time.
I ain't have been there.
Bro, when I tell you, when Throw That Ass in the Circle came on, the club got hype. Like,
yeah.
All the women jumped on the floor. It was like, that was the liveest song of the night. And it shocked. I mean, I love the song, but it shocked the hell out of me that everybody else loved it as much as I did.
Man, appreciate it.
I'm like, all right. Man,
appreciate
much
that.
Much love, bro.
My sister liked it. I'm like, hey, get that song. She was like, I like that song. Like, I was like, all right. I was surprised, man.
That video going to be epic, man. it's top of the line. Top of the line.
It's going to be one of the BET Uncut videos.
No. We kept it pretty PG. You know, because we finna make them wake the fuck up. When they see this video, you know, now they know they got to go. They video budgets got to be a little bigger to step on the level we on right now. You see what I'm saying?
We ain't half stepping.
Yeah, they ain't half stepping. It's square business. Everything is quality.
This one ain't gonna get banned from YouTube.
YouTube banned this. They cutting themselves short from views.
Yeah.
For real. YouTube, you banned this. You better wake the fuck up, man. We going to another site. And we going to make another motherfucking site boom.
Nigga ain't going to even get on YouTube no more. You banned now.
Getting a little loud. Yeah, getting a little loud.
Okay.
It's okay.
I got time.
I understand, man. I'm going to turn up. If anybody was asleep, I bet they wake the fuck up now.
Oh, yeah. Most definitely.
So you got a movie coming out.
Movie. It was supposed to drop on Valentine's Day, but you know how girls is, they in and out. So you know we had to get some a female that was to replace another female that was actually serious about the acting. This is almost done. Yep. And so it's gonna be crazy.
Yeah.
I can't really give y'all too much information on that. Fresh know what I'm talking about. It's gonna be crazy. There's a bunch of twists. It's I don't even want to tell you this, but it's like a musical, you know. I'm okay.
Hey, he getting booty in it.
Oh yeah. Hey. Okay. A whole scene.
I don't know.
Hey, a whole scene. Just like DMX on Belly. I'm getting it in.
You know, everybody movie gotta have some getting down in it.
Hey, let the fans know the title.
It's called A Fucked Up Love Story.
It's
fucked up.
Yeah. Sounds like a ghetto music. I don't say ghetto music, hip hop musical.
Yep, that's exactly what it's like.
Already.
Everybody been through, you know, a lot of fucked up love stories in their life, so they don't feel it.
That's life.
They gonna love it.
I don't think they've been through this though.
Lifetime. Everybody got their own different struggles, but everybody get them.
All right, man.
True that.
Man, we about to go to this next song with both y'all. What y'all know about it with Lil Ronny and MykFresh.
Hey, this song wake the
that's
fuck up.
That's exclusive though. Yeah, it's on the outside. I hope y'all know that.
Hey, everybody, calm down. Mike, it's getting loud in here. All right, we got a TMI exclusive. Okay, we got excited. We just found out ourselves, man.
Yeah. This on my new mixtape. Wake the fuck up. This one of them. Wake up.
All right, everybody.
What you know about it? Lil Ronny and MykFresh. Let's go.
Some niggas I never named. Lil niggas on a bigger and better thing. big money, big money. How we do it, get money. And if you ain't about that, then you ain't got shit for me. I ain't never clocked out. Money made me pop out. Come between me and that. Get your ass knocked out. Like, if you play with my bread, we will leave your ass dead. Motherfuck what you said, you'll be covered in red.
You'll be covered in red.
Like, oh, oh, oh. I don't wanna hurt nobody, but they come in hustling with you, know about it. Head busting with you, know about it. Pussy on my cell phone. Got haters cause I'm paid and I'm well known. Tell them catch me in traffic, I'm well gone. Niggas be acting like they hoe with Chanel on.
What the hell wrong with these bitches? These niggas be snitching. I'm about to give you hoes something to tell on. Knock you on your ass, make you break a tailbone. In high school, I was making music, Zac Efron, goddamn.
Don't call my phone for no favors. Now one of y'all help me through these mazes. Flipping through these motherfucking bands like pages. Trying to slow my niggas down, as in and out the cages.
Outrageous, we getting money, that's why they hate us. Don't press our buttons, nigga, we don't play station. These niggas can't see me, I think they need LASIK. They wanna be me like acne, just face it.
Just face it, y'all can't fuck with my squad. FamLife 700, I'ma ride. All in your baby mama, I pie. Hear me coming around the corner, see your bitch inside.
Like it's a curfew, but she gon' tell me come back when you go to work, fool. And if you walk in trippin', I'ma murk you. Spray your ass, no perfume, hold up, hold up.
Big money, big money,
big money, big money.
How we do it, get money.
How we do it, get money.
And if you ain't bout that,
if you ain't bout that,
then you ain't got shit for me.
Ain't got shit for me.
I ain't never clocked out.
I ain't never clocked out.
Money made me pop out.
Money made me pop out.
Come between me and that. Get your ass knocked out.
Like, oh. If you play with my bread, we will leave your ass dead. Motherfuck what you said, you'll be covered in red.
You'll be covered in red.
Like, oh, oh, oh. I don't wanna hurt nobody, but they come in hustling with you, know about it. Head busting with you, know about it.
Probably nothing, ain't no discussion. Them niggas talking down it like a small rubber. We busting, I gave his bitch a dick, she running back like TJ Duckett. He mad cause this hoe let me beat like DJ Mustard. DJ
running around the country on my big dog shit. Look at how I'm living, don't give me for a trick. Clucks made me sick, thinking MykFresh a lick. Hot Cheeto eating assholes always on my dick.
Hot chew, cause I'm sick, nigga. If you spot a dollar, then I'm with the shits, nigga. Used to be broke, well, I guess I got fixed, nigga. I take a bitch, nigga, then call you a bitch, nigga. Fuck you mean, bitch, nigga.
Got these boys jealous, they don't ever tell us. See, I like yellers, I don't like fellas. Catch me rooftop with some women that's gon' let us. Notice I say women got a grown woman fetish.
Kick a nigga down for the cash flow. Spit in his face, disrespect him, I'm an asshole. Collect tell her bags as I pass gone. Fuck being a rapper, nigga, I already had hoes.
Baby, mama fucker, better check my list. Be very, very, very careful who you kiss. Fucked another nigga girl and he had a fit. Last time I trusted a bitch, I had a pick.
Big money, big money.
Big money, big money.
How we do it, get money.
How we do it, get money.
And if you ain't bout that,
if you ain't bout that,
then you ain't got shit for me.
You ain't got shit for me.
I ain't never clocked out.
I ain't never clocked out.
Money made me pop out.
Money made me pop out.
Come between me and that.
Come between me and that.
Get your ass knocked out.
Like, oh. If you play with my bread, we will leave your ass dead. Motherfuck what you said, you'll be covered in red.
You'll be covered in red.
Like, oh. Nobody, but they come in hustling with you, know about it. Head busting with you, know about it.
Big money, big money.
Big money, big money.
And if you ain't bout that,
if you ain't bout that,
between me and that,
nigga, pop, pop, pop.
Like, oh. If you play with my brain, we will leave you with that motherfucker. What you said, you'll be covered in red.
You'll be covered in red.
Like, oh.
TMI, oh yeah, oh yeah, yeah.
Wake the fuck up.
What's going on? We're back with Immense Music. This is Cochise and Droski. We're here with Little Ronny, MuthaF, and MykFresh of FamLife Entertainment.
TMI, yeah, yeah, oh yeah.
Oh, really? That sounded like the drum.
Had to hit that one.
Yeah,
yeah,
yeah.
I know you sound too.
Yeah, I like that.
All
right. That's what it is. That's what it is, man. Now, if you know anything about Little Ronnie MuthaF, you might know about his famous box.
Yeah.
The box.
Yeah, yeah.
The box.
The box.
If you don't know about it, look it up.
Yeah.
But you better do it quick because you say you about to retire.
I'm about to retire. It's going to retire. I'm hanging the streak up in the stands, man. I'm done with this hair, man.
Man, hey, my homeboy called Strip Club the Shake, man. What? How the Shakers gonna know you without the box?
Man, they already noticed me. I don't even wear. I ain't probably pulled my hair out since January.
January.
So it's been the same reaction here there. I'm done with it, man. I'm done with it.
They know your face now. They ain't
got to
see
your face. And that's all I wanted. That's all I needed them to do.
Yeah.
Okay.
Right on.
Man, tell us a little bit about FamLife. Y'all both on FamLife. FamLife
label.
Yeah, tell us a little bit about that.
Started in Oakland, California.
In Oakland, huh?
Yep. CEO named Juju. You know, Juju. We a team, all us very family-oriented. Whether it's we're real family or whether we homeboys, we move like family. Everything in-house. Our videos, family, our features, family, everything just family. Family-oriented, fam life. You know what I'm saying? We trying to take care of mamas, put our mamas in big houses.
Yep.
It's fam life, you heard me?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, for real. All right.
It's all good. Built against loyalty.
It did.
How to hear about y'all today in Oakland being in Dallas and Fort Worth?
Nah, they based in Oakland, but, you know, it's a few of them out here. It's a lot of them out here in Dallas. So you got to hear about us. You're in Dallas.
All right. That's what's up. That's what it is.
Man, big topic in the news here in Texas is this legalization of marijuana. You know, we keep coming back to it. You know, me, MykFresh, no.
Is it Mikey coming back to
it?
Yeah, hey, I'm he's super excited about it.
So, yeah, I'm real hyped up. But, I mean, not everybody blows. So, I mean, Lil Ryan, question. You were talking earlier, you were saying that you don't smoke. It's a personal choice, man.
Never have, never will. Because I just see how people be, I don't know, they not they sell.
Yeah, right on.
I got too many partners that I know here there. Yeah. Like I barely drink too. Like I don't like to be not me. To feel like I'm not me. And people like when people tell me like it make me more chill. Well, that mean that you wasn't chill before that. That mean that's not you. You making yourself something that's not you.
So you tell me you make all them wild crazy videos. That's me. You be sober. Yeah.
That's me, man.
Yeah. I was watching, looking at that ho-ho-ho video. I'm like, this dude got to be fucked up.
I'm most definitely sober, man. Like, I'm a sober head. I got to always be liable to see what's going on with myself.
I respect that.
If I'm sad that day, man, I'm actually sad. Like, I feel like any drug is like an emotion changer.
And like a crutch?
Like, yeah. It just changes your emotion. You see what I'm saying? Like, if when you drink, it give you like a little more energy, you know, that you didn't have. Like, I like to be natural. Like, if I want you to really see how I'm feeling. Like, you know what I'm saying? I was just high that day. That's why I wasn't tripping. You know what I mean? Like, now I'm tripping. I'm tripping.
Yeah, you want to own the trip?
Yeah. I was tripping that day.
Like, I got anger management issues.
Like, take me this. My friends might slap somebody one day and be like, you know, only reason I ain't slapped you the other day because I was high.
Yeah.
Me, I'm gonna slap you that day because I'm not. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah. Man.
So you get a high slide with me.
You get a high slide,
regardless, huh?
You dig?
So you one of the high heads of the group or what?
You say high head?
Yeah, high
head. Ronnie got a hotter temper than me. He just gonna smack you the first time. I'm gonna smack you the second time because the first time I was high.
All right.
Yeah, you know how it is. You saw we be things get to you a little bit quicker. Just a little bit quicker.
Yep.
Right. You threw a wrench in his whole game. He was about to talk about how great weed was.
you can still speak about it. I would like to hear about it. I've never experienced it, so I can't knock it. You see what I'm saying?
You've heard enough about it. You know what I'm saying? You got homeboys there.
Oh, yeah.
Man, so what else y'all got coming up?
Life,
already. You guys got shows. You know?
Oh, yeah, we say boo.
We've been on the road for years.
Yeah.
Like I said, we're trying to take it to the next level. We're trying to get our mom in these big old houses.
These big houses, man. Yeah.
So that's what's next. We on the road to getting that done.
Yeah, you know what I'm saying?
We've been out here doing shows, making the girls shake their booty for a long time.
Right, yeah.
Time for the paperwork.
Like, you know what I'm saying? Job at that.
I see.
So my question is this. So which city do y'all like to perform in the most? Which city, you know?
City or state?
Either way,
you can't really pick, man. It's
if he say one of them, I'm going to say the other one. I know it's two.
All right, well, let me tell you. What city got the best looking ladies, man?
Houston.
Houston?
Oh, yeah. Okay, I can.
You said best looking ladies, but at first you said favorite place to perform.
Yeah, you're right now. Yeah, he said favorite place to perform.
I already knew he had some bad girls. Houston, hey, say, man, left to right, you just, yeah, in there, just an abundance, a bundle of them. Like, oh my God.
It's infinity.
The ugly ones
never run out.
Yeah,
right up. The ugly ones keep coming.
Yeah. You been to Beaumont at all?
No, but you know it's like Houston.
They around the corner.
They probably all getting the same water.
Yeah.
Whatever in the water, they getting the same bottles of water down there.
Yeah, so, but see, with Beaumont, Houston, we have the attitude. So you know, let them come.
Hey, I don't get no attitude in H.
Oh, he got money. I'm sorry.
Hey, I don't get that attitude.
I get the love.
Man, that's
the
benefit of having money.
Man,
that's
the performance goal.
It's two cities that's live, and I know both of them. He know both of them. Yeah, so if he say one, I'ma say the other one.
It's actually a lot of places that's just live.
I'm talking about the most live is though.
Yeah.
You got Austin
and the other one, Arkansas.
Oh, where?
Yeah. Austin and Arkansas is two places
that go up through the roof. Now, you know, everywhere gonna turn up, but
Chicago live too.
Yeah, they really? Yeah. Everywhere gonna turn up, but it's like we already celebrities in these places.
So is it safe to say those two are the ones that show you the most love? I wouldn't say the most love,
but the way they show their love is more. Cause you got places like places in Mississippi where they love you. But they just they don't show it. They love you. You know they gonna bow their head cause they love you.
Yeah.
But you know they're certain
not,
places
not gonna be live.
Yeah. Yeah.
They gonna when you done when you got to stay they all praise.
They gonna dap you up, man. You go hard. Ain't that? Yeah. Yeah.
But so, why you performing? You looking at them and they giving you that look like.
Yeah. They
yeah. You got to be on your own vibe cause they're key.
Yeah, right on.
What about performing in your home city, Dallas and Fort Worth?
It's crazy. You know, you know everything word for word. We get to perform extra songs.
Because
outside, it's only songs that made it to them.
Uh-huh.
Here, they know everything. Yeah. So the show be longer. Yeah. Sweat, you know, you get a better workout at home.
Yeah. Girls I done already touched on in the crowd. Yes, Lord.
Yes, Lord.
All right, well, we're going to go to some commercials, pay these bills, and come back with some music. And then when we get back, we going to, you don't mind if y'all do a little freestyle?
We don't care.
I don't mind at all.
Yeah, we don't have a little freestyle.
I'm like, baby.
Yeah. All right. See ya. Cochise and Droski. We got FamLife Entertainment, the bitter little Ronny MuthaF and MykFresh.
Yeah.
All right, now, these boys been here talking that noise like they can freestyle. They said we can do whatever we want. They gonna go. We can throw words at them. They gonna go. Tell them what to do.
Believe that.
They said they just gonna go and not stop. They promised us something impressive.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? So here, we gonna let them have it. Little Ronny MykFresh.
Hey. Hey.
I'm gonna go first. Hey.
I'm gonna go first. Cause I'm gonna go worse.
Worse?
He gonna go last. Then I'm put y'all on blast.
Woo.
Cause y'all niggas don't freestyle.
Nah.
We young niggas and we wild.
Wow.
We young niggas, we don't smile.
Smile.
We'll make the gun go bow.
Bow. We be getting money for the mile. We be getting money for the mile. I clean my ass with Dove. Y'all clean your ass with Dow. If it ain't buy no money,
nah.
My number you shouldn't dial. Beat the pussy up. Make that little pussy smile.
Hey, make that little pussy smile. Make that little pussy grin.
Grin.
Make that little pussy come.
Come.
Before I'd even put it in.
Ooh.
I'm a real nigga. I'm a dog. Yeah, I got that law.
Law.
I don't miss no calls.
No.
I ain't sitting, don't raw.
Pillows. Talk about pillows.
Pillows. Soft ass like pillows.
Yeah.
Soft ass like pillows.
Hey.
Oh, I cannot be a hero. The mean that I won't save her.
Save her.
Mean that I won't save her. Hold on.
I kick it too much flavor.
Flavor.
That mean that I won't save her. I fuck a braider.
Braider.
I fuck a weaver.
Weaver.
I don't damn, I don't believe her.
Nah.
Bitch gonna tell you some lies.
Lies.
Nigga don't act surprised.
No.
Your girl fucking your homeboy, your partners, and your. Hold on. I done fucked up. Where the beat at, man?
Crank it up a little bit for her. Let her hear that. I think I rapped on this beat too.
Did you?
That's a choir boy beat.
Yeah.
I already know.
Alright, you wanna try it again, man?
Yeah, we already know y'all.
I'll give you one
last.
Yeah,
we
here.
One last time y'all started out.
We here.
The pillow threw y'all off.
Nah, I didn't.
Nah, it put on it. Yeah, nah.
Alright.
Yeah.
It was just louder than
that. Hey, it ain't gonna get no louder than that.
When you hear everybody hearing it, level, like y'all in the studio playing.
Right. Okay.
Yeah. So everything here now, everybody hear y'all
already.
Okay.
All right.
Hey. We ain't got no topic.
We ain't got no topic.
Still
gonna pop it.
Yeah,
go. Pop that pussy for fresh. Pop that pussy the best.
Found life. Damn right. Damn right.
Damn right.
The bitch know I laid a ham right.
Right, right.
Damn right. Yeah. Found life. Damn right.
Yeah, yeah.
Damn right. Your bitch know I laid a ham right.
Laid a ham
put the
right.
Shit on cam, right?
Put the shit on cam, right?
Cam?
Put the shit on film.
Film.
Shout out Halfpint Film.
Film.
Made the bitch lose a limb.
Limb.
Cause I'ma hit the bitch hard.
Hard.
Make the bitch scream for God.
God.
Sorry, God, I'm cursing.
Cursing.
Hit the thing, have it squirting.
Squirting. Hit the thing, have it squirting. She love the way I be working.
Working.
I'm getting so much pussy that at night I don't be jerking.
Jerking.
I'm saying I'm just for real.
Real.
Got a whole lot of diamonds all up in my grill now. Let me chill.
Chill.
Go right here. For real.
For real. Go right here for real.
Ooh.
Take the shit off your wrist. Put the shit on my teeth. But make sure the shit glitz.
Ooh.
Y'all niggas some snakes.
Snakes.
Make sure it don't hiss.
Ooh.
I'll take your bitch.
Piss.
A bathroom, my piss.
Piss. A bathroom, my piss.
Hey.
Call that shit the restroom.
Yeah.
When I have sex with her,
yeah.
Come to my house, that's the best room.
Yeah.
That's her ex room, but I ain't worried about it.
Yeah.
Boy, get the nerve out.
Yeah. Yeah,
like
yeah,
a,
yeah.
I
eat your bitch pussy.
Pussy.
It tastes like candy.
Ew.
Then I'm hiding a bitch. So then I go to her pantry.
Pantry.
Then I go to her fridge.
Ooh.
Then I go long bridge.
Bridge.
I don't get no damn fuck the bitch that go to Fossil Ridge.
What?
And that's a real high school.
School.
MykFresh, I've been cool.
Cool.
Make the pussy wet like a pool.
Pool.
I don't give a damn. I'm a fool.
Fool.
I'm a goddamn meat dummy.
Dummy.
Nigga. Money in my tummy.
Money in my tummy. Nigga, I don't wear Amber Crumbie. My name is Lil Ronny.
Ronny.
This is rapping for dummies.
Dummies.
Get a nigga with the
hey,
get a
nigga
with the box top of Gumby.
Dummy.
Hey, jump on the mic. Go ahead, man. For dummies. Man, we ain't no food. Hold on, hold up. I'ma take you to school. Man, ain't even doing it. Man, ain't for real. Man, I'm just chilling, man. I'm just gonna chill, cause we right here with fam. Like, man, you goddamn right. If you don't feel this, then motherfucker, you.
You know what I'm saying?
Hey,
there it is.
Man,
Mike. Little Ronnie, MuthaF, Mike. Yeah, Fred. Yeah, I mean, hold on.
Featuring Mike Droski.
Yeah, feel it. Mike Droski on the track, baby.
We can tell y'all do that. Because y'all was going back and forth.
Yeah, yeah.
The people could tell, but he did like four, you did y'all.
Yeah,
yeah,
I like that.
Yeah,
I like that.
Man.
Yeah,
thanks. Hey, so where can the people find you, man?
Man, TheRunningMuthaF.com, TheRunningMuthaF, everything. LILRONNYMOTHAF. Book me at 214-392-8696. Baby, let's get it.
Easily. And I got the same book info. You can find me online, MykFresh, MykFresh. No space. MykFresh, MykFresh, no space.
MykFresh, no space.
No space.
Last question.
Y'all do a lot of booty music. What's your favorite booty club?
In the D. Do a lot of booty music.
Man, my big brother's opening up a new club, so I'm gonna have to say that.
The warehouse
out of Regal Row.
Booty
it's
booty.
Regal Row is right here. It's new. It's in Dallas.
Hey, can we get some passes to get in?
Look.
We can make that happen.
And you know what? I'm gonna tell y'all another spot. I like BT's Cabaret.
Yeah. In the
beautiful
front.
Work.
Yeah.
Right down the street from Flash. See, you be going to Flash, huh?
Look,
Flash live too, but see, BTs, they new.
The white girls, though.
Nah, no, Flash got them. They got them big booty bitch from the south.
We'll be okay.
For real. All
right.
All
I'm
right.
a DG's man.
Okay.
DG, I like DG's too.
Pretty faces
and a nice waist. You understand what I'm saying?
True that. High
ass drink. They waist training and ass gaining, man.
You did.
Yeah.
All right. Well, thank y'all for coming, man. We appreciate y'all.
Ain't
for
no thing, bro.
Let me look a little Ronnie MuthaF and MykFresh. Good for him. Yeah. Ghetto Gumbo.
Yes, love.
And, wake the fuck up.
Man. Yep, yep.
All right, man. This is Benny Mint's Music. TMI Radio. This is Cochise.
And this is Mike Droski.
FamLife. FamLife. What?
Yeah. Ooh.